The finance department says the Philippine fiscal position is steadily improving, and with the continued reopening of the economy in 2022, they expect tax revenues to return to pre-pandemic levels, which will help reduce the budget deficit, expected to hit 1.8 trillion pesos or 9.5% of GDP this year. Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez says this should allow them to start whittling down debt incurred to finance the COVID-19 response, including the 540 billion peso loan government took from the Philippine Central Bank.
The first 10 months of 2021, our gross borrowing amounted to 2.7 trillion pesos. Of this total amount, 2.2 trillion came from domestic sources.
The full payment of the loan is expected this week, ahead of a January 12 deadline. The finance department says it will still be seeking additional liquidity support, but it will only ask the central bank for 300 billion pesos. Dominguez says the fiscal position of the Philippines is still sound, and they can actually afford to be flexible in case new COVID-19 variants, including Omicron, disrupt the economy again.
I don't know what the new variants will be. I don't know how virulent they will be, how necessary it will be to provide fiscal support. I don't know, okay? But we are ready.
However, Dominguez admits debt will be one of the key problems for the next administration next year, alongside inflation, poverty, and climate change.
How to grow out of the debt that we have, to make sure that our debt gets reduced from about, we will peak at about 63-64% of our GDP, up from 39% in 2019. To bring it back down to around 40% of our GDP, we have to grow at something like 6 or 6.5% a year. That is the main challenge of the next administration.
The DOF is now preparing a transition plan for the next administration, and they will be recommending a roadmap toward fiscal consolidation. He also noted that while the whole world has been facing the same financial troubles, the Philippines has been able to weather the storm and avoid credit rating downgrades thanks to the fiscal prudence of the Duterte administration and the success of the Aquino administration before them in preserving and conserving finances. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.